Sinji over here in Winners Finals. Both these players showing some pretty impressive performances today.
Is this another episode of Sinji versus John?
Yep, definitely a matchup that's been seen a few times before at least.
Where's the popcorn? Actually, screw the popcorn. Where's the pillows?
Yeah, well, hey, you know, we're seeing hits are being put out.
Sure.
Suns are being saluted. Okay. Sinji's looking around the grocery. Like, which kind of fruits should I get today? All right, that back air is going to get Sinji a little bit of control, but Numbers is right back on stage. So what do you think about this matchup, Mr. Dumbass?
I think I need a fall. Seems like an alright matchup. It should be whoever's more campy win. But it looks like it's not going to be that way. I got money on Sinji on there. How about you?
Let's see. If I had to pick a favorite here, I think Numbers is going to take it. Sinji is a strong player, and he definitely would be like the underdog of this matchup, if anything, if he were to win. But I just think Numbers is gonna pull through. He's too familiar with, you know, other people's campy playstyles. Yeah, Sinji must have known that Numbers wasn't gonna go for the ledge and get a re-grab, so should have been an easy read, but Sinji kinda dropped the ball on that one.
That's frame one, right? How can I jump?
I'm not sure about the frame data on Pac-Man's up-E, but it looks pretty fast.
Hydrant?
Yeah, even the ledge trump isn't enough for Pac-Man right now. He's definitely not having an easy time closing out the stock. Zap that key to take the stock. Like I was being nice and very respectful of those sun salutations. But yeah, Numbers is definitely running away with this right now. Basically just trying to see if Numbers is going to run into one of his traps. But Numbers is like, okay, I can stay here all day. Trouble really taking John Numbers' stocks here, so, and he's got that deficit on top of that. At this point, Sinji's just hoping for some kind of like hard read that's gonna turn this match around. But with a character like Pac-Man, it's definitely not that comeback kind of character where, you know, you just need one good read. You need a lot of good reads. Trying to put this bell in an optimal place, but isn't able to do anything with it. He does bait out that sun salutation from Numbers, though, which got him that little punish, and you keep doing that sort of thing. It's his one chance in this match. Ooh, okay, Numbers is doing some baiting of his own. He's Z-dropping that cherry. Does not want to let go. Numbers just did that F tilt right over the hydrant.
With my money.
I think I heard Numbers just banned Lilat.
He only bans Lilat.
I mean, I think it's a pretty horrible stage. Lots of reasons to ban that one.
That's all right. Just make sure your character can recover on it. Beef is probably barely. One, go! Okay, go!
Okay, nobody's committing to anything big right now. I mean, hey, that's the matchup, but... Numbers actually catching the cherry off stage. And Sinji finally hits one of his hydrants off stage. He's been trying it for so long. Okay, I actually thought the cherry disappeared for a minute, but it looks like it disappears when she does the sun salutation. That would have been really amazing and beautiful if he actually pulled it off, but just a little bit off. It's basically just a matter of tech zone. Ooh, and the numbers going really deep, but maybe he was just trying to bait out something from Sinji. Wow, despite the fact that the hydrant was perfectly timed, you know, just having such a hard time killing Wii Fit. Okay, that's a nice option coverage from Sinji, putting the trampoline right there, but he misses the punish. Yeah, he keeps getting numbers into these bad positions where, you know, I'm thinking, okay, he's got numbers in a bad position above him or something along those lines, and he's just not able to close it out.
He's getting so close, but it's not catching.
Yeah, hopefully Sinji can keep his cool, because I know when you keep just messing up some of your kill confirms like that, and when you keep messing up, you know, certain moves that would have gotten you the kill, it can definitely throw your game off a little bit. Yeah, same old story. I don't even want to say the same thing again, so I think we're both thinking the same thing. Viewers are probably thinking the same thing.
Finally,
I actually thought that wasn't going to kill for a minute.
Someone needs to make a video compilation of just this one match of how many screw-ups Sinji did.
Alright, we're almost 4 minutes into this match. And Sinji has a pretty comfortable lead, so at this point, I would not be too surprised if we actually went to a timeout. All Sinji has to do is play safe at this point. He doesn't really have too many approach options, so you're not going to see him trying to go in on refit too much. It's like, as a character, Pac-Man wants space, but Wii Fit Trainer also wants space. You know, you want to see somebody go in, but it's tough in this matchup.
Ground really wants to stop.
Honestly, this is the point where I feel like if I was playing this matchup, I might get so frustrated at just playing this game that it would mess me up. But just like that, John Lumbers is going to take Sinji's first stock, and he has a chance at getting the crown.
Ooh, that was beautiful.
Okay, Sinji's aim is getting better, so with that improved aim, he's actually able to get some of these long-distance punishes like that hydrant. He is giving Numbers a few tools to work with, though, as he throws all these items out. And actually, we saw recently when Bars went up against Sinji, it seemed like Bars really didn't know what the optimal attacks to hit the hydrant with to get it flying back towards Sinji. But Numbers knows just what to hit the hydrant with. And we are going to go to a timeout, and that is going to be Sinji. Number is just wanting to jump off the ledge and end his life after that one. And,
I'm gonna die first.
We got them playing around in sudden death. Just so you guys know, this is not an actual, this is not a usual part of our tournament rules here. But, hey, sudden death. Always good fun in games. Just kidding, guys. Just to clarify, it's actually 1-1.
Easy
one by person. Okay, I hear a Dreamland then.
What a lilac.
Okay, I didn't see what that stage was, but okay, we're going to Omega Guar Plains, one of the best Omegas. Top 5 Omega. Top 10, maybe. Okay. What? Well, all I can say is that the Great Cave Offensive on Omega is definitely a top 3 Omega stage. Alright, we got more fruit flying around, sun's flying around. Yeah, I gotta say, this music is bringing back some memories of that first Xenoblade game for me.
I never played that.
But let me try and actually relate that to the match. It's pretty relaxing music for this match. So I feel like it's pretty appropriate since, you know, you're not going to see things happening too fast. You're not going to see these rapid up-tilt combos that we've seen in a lot of our matches involving Ryu. That eventually we're going to see one of them just take some risks that work in their favor. Take the right risks at the right time, I guess. Breaking at 72% to 65%. So a super even, what's the word I'm looking for here? I was looking for a word for this type of battle. It's just like a battle of endurance. How well can you play while potentially getting bored over, you know, nobody going in? Okay, sorry about any of you hearing that. We got some people dropping chairs in the background. Who knows what goes on at this place? Although I do have to say, it's unfortunate for Sinji that when he does go in and gets a really nice punish, or a really nice confirm into something that should kill, it takes so much for him to kill Wii Fit.
I think think Sinji keeps throwing the apple. Sinji keeps on power killing it, it's not working.
I think apple is one of the first that can kill, right?
Yeah, it is. But Nebulous keeps on power killing everybody that comes.
Ooh, and there we go. It's a pretty nice mix up there, using the hydrant to, you know, take care of numbers and mixing it up with the apple right afterwards.
He held down on that one.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he wanted to grab the ledge or if he thought that he was going to catch numbers off guard. Ooh, but he does get that bell into a kill confirm.
That was nice, but it just missed.
Yeah, nice of Sinji getting out of the way with that trampoline. You would think he's pretty vulnerable with that grab, but the hitbox lasts for a long time, so Nebulous definitely did not want to run into it. Alright, Sinji's trying to see if he can do something with this Galaga. It is one of Pac-Man's trickier projectiles. Okay, Sinji is putting on some pretty nice shield pressure, using the Galaga to set up an opening for him to come on and put in some normal attacks. Good thing is, though, with numbers in the lead, we may see something really smart and clutch from Sinji if he can shine under pressure right now. Oh, yeah, that's right. Hadn't even looked at the time until now. Time flies, sort of. I think I understand why both of these guys wanted to mess around in sudden death before. Oh, and Sinji's still living. Both of them were probably like, oh, sudden death, now my character can finally kill. And Nebulous is going to take this with 2 seconds on the clock, taking Sinji's stock. But, you know, he had a pretty heavy percent lead, so he's definitely going to win that either way.
Take the folders of the last four videos. Put them in
one. Go!
Sorry, guys. We still have a few audio issues to work out with this, so apologies if that was kind of grating on your ears. But let's get back into this match. We're going into Game 4. And Nebulous has a pretty comfortable lead. It seems like he knows what to do against Sinji right now, so I expect him to take this. Yeah, well, in the set, he has a you know, somewhat comfortable lead. He is up 2-1.
One of these guys is trying to break the other shield.
The key is out, so it's still in play. And Nebulous has the key now. He might be able to do something with it. Ooh, okay. still holding on to that key. He doesn't want to throw it. He's just like, okay, let me do the Z-drop to try and keep it. See if I can do something with the Z-drop. Wow, and that key is so strong that as soon as he lets it go, that's all it takes to hit that hydrant. Is this the same key I think that we've been seeing for like a whole minute?
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, wait a minute, did Sinji pull out another key? That's the same key?
Nope, that was the same old key.
Ooh. Spell, but he wasn't able to get much out of it, sadly.
He was trying to go for that bell, the footstool, and all that stuff.
Okay, yeah, it sounds like a tricky combo to pull together, but that bell might have been Sinji's one opportunity to really solidify the set. Ooh. Oh, sorry, I meant to say solidify the game. But right now, Sinji is up in this game, so he's definitely looking to at least make this set 2-2 and stand a chance at winning. Wow, Galago in right through Sun Salutation. Yeah, really nice shield pressure from Sinji, but Numbers is able to just make his way out. Ooh, really nice combination from Sinji, using that Galago to go and put in a string of hits. Would have been nice if a lot of things landed in this set. Like that.
He absorbed it.
Just so you guys know, Brawl Grand Finals coming up for you Brawl fans out there, all three of you.
Hey, I'm a Brawl fan.
Alright, but getting back into this match, it's definitely looking like Sinji turned things around. So, you know, you gotta say, although this is one of those slower matchups, you always gotta give it to players that can actually, like, turn things around. And you gotta always appreciate when it's not just, you know, one player just completely demolishing the other. Okay, Numbers trying to smack Sinji out of the way and take care of that first stock. Just like that, he does manage to smack away his first stock with that forward tilt. Has a pretty big deficit right now, but he's definitely trying to still see if he can win this, and then that will be a pretty quick grand winner's final for him. True, he has a minute to make something happen. Ooh, okay, since you almost got hit by that bell. That ain't mess. Yes! Sinji does get the kill off trampoline. Definitely a pretty hype way to get that kill. But he's gonna have to win at least one more if he wants to win winners.
Let's go, Sinji!
Yeah, game 5,
boys. Hey, hey, we go unbiased here.
Take time.
What happened to unbiased commentary, dumbass?
Sorry, I'm
supposed to say, let's go someone. I hope somebody wins. I hope somebody wins in a fair and exciting way.
I don't. Use whatever it takes to win.
One, go!
Oh, choice for the fifth game.
Yeah, I haven't seen the stage in a while, but it's a pretty looking stage. And when you're going to have a 6 minute or close to 6 minute match, you know, you want to have nice visuals, nice music. Just make it a relaxing experience. Don't let the fact that it's taking so long stress you out. Okay, wow, Hydra's going right for the trampoline. I actually wasn't sure what would happen in that situation. So far 2 minutes in, and this match is still ridiculously even. Both players on their first stock. I'm trying to make this as exciting as possible.
You can't.
Trying here.
You can't. Be honest with yourself.
Trying to clean this out with some yoga moves. And I'd like to talk about favorites again, like we were. I mean, my favorite, like I was saying before, was Numbers. I figured, you know, he's gonna take this. But at this point, I feel like it's just a question of, okay, who's gonna be less patient? You know?
No one has died yet. That's gonna be me.
You know, who drank their coffee or energy drink or whatever in the morning? Because I don't know about other people. For me, that makes me anxious. So if I was in this kind of situation and maybe I was, you know, super caffeinated, I would probably be the first to just throw something random out. Sling Citation's still not going to kill, even at 130%. There you go, somewhere around there. Well, at this point, Sinji is at 148%. If Sinji takes another hit from something and does not die, it's going to be frustrating. Not only for John, but for the viewers, too.
Sinji's trying to recatch that feat. I don't think this is the stage for it.
Alright. Sinji, 156%, but still living, and F-Tilt's going to take it. Does have that deep breathing, so hopefully it's going to be in his favor. He's lost the deep breathing now, but he's already got another Sun Citation almost fully charged. Numbers is probably thinking, like, you know what? It might take a while, but I'm just going to play patient, close out this set. He's probably thinking it would be nice to have it finish in less than 40 seconds, but if it takes a full 40 seconds, you know, he can still win. Now Number is with an even more comfortable lead. It's definitely looking like there's not any hope for Sinji. And just like that...
Next time on Nebulous, Sinji.
I think Sinji saw there was no hope there and just decided, you know what, this is not fun.
There was no hope right there.
Yeah, I was at like 130, so maybe that's why.